ओके हरे कृष्ण. सो विल स्टार्ट विद प्रेयर्स, कैन ऑल रिपीट आफ्टर मी. ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय, ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय, ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय. हरे कृष्ण. सो आज का हमारा टॉपिक है लाइफ लेसन्स फ्रॉम बलि महाराज. सो आप में से कौन ऐसे लोग हैं जो बलि महाराज का नाम जानते हैं, अगर उनके बारे में कुछ आइडिया है? ओके ठीक है, तो हम बलि महाराज के बारे में जानेंगे, बट उनसे पहले उनका थोड़ा हिस्ट्री के बारे में जानेंगे कि वो है कौन, उनके पिता कौन थे, या फिर उनका बैकग्राउंड क्या है, वो जानने की कोशिश करें. कोई बता सकते ये कौन है? ये जो भी फोटोज है, who are these personalities?
12 महाजन्स.
हाँ, 12 महाजन्स. तो कोई बताना चाहेगा कि 12 महाजन्स कौन कौन है, स्टार्टिंग विद दी लेफ्ट टॉप मोस्ट. हाँ, लॉर्ड ब्रह्मा, दिस वन वेरी इजी, लॉर्ड शिवा, या फिर ये सुखदेव गोस्वामी. सुखदेव गोस्वामी इज द सन ऑफ व्यास मुनि, व्यास मुनि के बेटे हैं. सो इज द रिसाइटर ऑफ द श्रीमद् भागवतम. फिर ये इज अ फेमस पर्सनैलिटी, प्रहलाद महाराज. फिर ये नारद मुनि, नारद मुनि, जनक महाराज. अच्छा, मैं बोलूंगा कि शायद किसी ने ना पहले से देखा रहेगा, तो आई वुड से कि जिन्होंने नहीं देखा वो ट्राई कीजिए. तो यहाँ से या सो इन मेनी ऑफ द क्लासेस वी हैव डिस्कस्ड दिस स्लाइड्स. सो इफ समबडी ऑलरेडी नोज, मे बी वी कैन गिव अ चांस टू अदर्स, एंड देन मतलब अगर किसी को नहीं आया तो देन वी कैन से. ठीक है, तो ही इज जनक महाराज, फादर ऑफ सीता. ये कौन है? ये चार कुमार है. फिर ये है कपिल मुनि, सनत सनातन, सनत कुमार और सनानंद, चार नाम. और ये है कपिल मुनि. कपिल मुनि इज एन इंकारनेशन ऑफ लॉर्ड कृष्णा हिमसेल्फ. ये है मनु, स्वयंभुवा मनु. सो मनु संहिता आपने पढ़ा होगा, मनुस्मृति, जिसमें लॉज फॉर मैनकाइंड लिखा है, तो उनके ऑथर है मनु. ये कौन है? काफी फेमस है, हाँ, भीष्म पितामह. और ये कौन है? हिंट है तो आज हमारे टॉपिक यही है, बलि महाराज. सो ये है बलि महाराज. और ये लास्ट महाजन, ये कौन है? किसी ने यमराज कहा, किसी ने कल्कि कहा, और कोई गेस? ओके, सो ही इज यमराज. व्हाई यमराज इज महाजन? बिकॉज यमराज वो पर्सन है जो डिसाइड करते हैं कि आफ्टर डेथ किसी को हेवन जाना है या हेल जाना है, या फिर कौन से टाइप का पनिशमेंट देना चाहिए. सो जो खुद जज होता है उनको पता होना चाहिए कि सही क्या है, गलत क्या है. इसलिए ही इज ऑल्सो वन ऑफ द महाजन. सो दीज आर 12 महाजन. यस ओके सॉरी. विजिबल है सबको ऑनलाइन भी? ठीक है. सो दीज आर द 12 महाजन. ये 12 महाजन है, तो इन्हें सारे शास्त्र का फुल नॉलेज इनके पास है. तो हमारे पास अगर कोई डाउट्स हो क्या सही है क्या गलत है, देन वी शुड ऑलवेज रिफर टू दिस महाजन्स एंड वी शुड गेट क्लैरिफिकेशन फ्रॉम देम. सो आज हमारे जो स्टडी के पात्र हैं, बलि महाराज, ही इज ऑल्सो वन ऑफ द महाजन, वो भी एक महाजन है, तो उनके बारे में हम जानेंगे। तो बलि महाराज के बारे में जानने से पहले हम उनके लाइव हिस्ट्री के बारे में जानते हैं, वो एग्जैक्टली कौन थे। ठीक है, अच्छा, इंडिया में एक सिस्टम है, मतलब जब कोई विवाह होता है या फिर कोई यज्ञ होता है तो गोत्र पूछते हैं। गोत्र क्या होता है, किसी को आइडिया? कास्ट, बट एग्जैक्टली कोई गोत्र का नाम बता सकते हो? हाँ, गौतम। तो गौतम गोत्र मतलब क्या होता है, मतलब कोई अगर गौतम गोत्र में, मतलब गौतम मुनि जो थे वो उनके मतलब पूर्वज थे, तो वैसे ही इनका आपने नाम सुना रहेगा, कश्यप मुनि। हाँ, तो कश्यप गोत्र भी एक बहुत ही फेमस गोत्र है। कश्यप मुनि कौन थे, किसी कोई बता सकते हैं? सप्तऋषि, मुझे एग्जैक्टली याद नहीं आ रहा, शायद वो सप्तऋषि में से एक थे। बट कश्यप मुनि को माना जाता है कि जितने सारे लिविंग एंटिटीज है उन सबके पिता है, मतलब जो भी हम देखते हैं, मनुष्य देखते हैं, दैत्य, दानव, सब सब देवास जो भी हैं उनके पिता है, मतलब उनसे ही आए। तो कश्यप मुनि के एक बेटे थे, क्या था उनका नाम? हिरण्यकश्यपु। हिरण्यकश्यपु ने सबने नाम तो सुना होगा, बहुत फेमस है। इस द फादर ऑफ होम, उनके बेटे का नाम है प्रहलाद महाराज। प्रहलाद महाराज के बेटे कौन थे, किसी को आइडिया? उनके बेटे का नाम है विरोचन। और विरोचन के बेटे का नाम क्या है? बलि महाराज। सो ये हमारे स्टडी के पात्र है आज, बलि महाराज। सो बलि महाराज के भी एक बेटे थे, कोई गेस कर सकता उनका नाम क्या? तो कृष्णा उनके साथ फाइट करते हैं, तो उनका नाम बानासुर है। बानासुर इज एन आसुर हैविंग 1000 आर्म्स, तो बलि महाराज के बेटे। तो अभी यहाँ पे मैंने एक कलरिंग सिस्टम किया है, इससे कुछ पता चल रहा है आपको, मतलब कलर क्यों किया मैंने इसे? या सो काफी अच्छा है, मतलब आपने पहचाना कि ये जो सैफ्रॉन में दे आर एक्चुअली डिवोटीज, बट ये डिवोटी होने के बावजूद भी उनके बेटे देखो डीमन है, फिर डीमन है उनका बेटा डिवोटी है, फिर उनका बेटा वापस डीमन है, फिर उनका बेटा वापस डिवोटी है, तो ऐसा क्यों है? कुछ अभी कोई गेस करना चाहिए ऐसा क्यों है? इस तरह एनी रीजन वाई ऐसा, मतलब जनरली अगर पिता डिवोटी है तो बेटा भी डिवोटी होना चाहिए, पिता अगर डीमन है तो बेटा भी डीमन होना चाहिए, पर ऐसे नहीं दिख रहा है यहाँ पे, यहाँ पे उल्टा ही दिख रहा है, मतलब डिवोटी के बेटे है डीमन है, डीमन के बेटे डिवोटी है, ऐसा क्यों हो रहा है? बहुत सिंपल है, आई एम नॉट आस्किंग अ वेरी डिफिकल्ट क्वेश्चन। कर्म, या कर्म इज वन थिंग, अनदर थिंग, मतलब जनरली एक बेटा कैसा होता है, मतलब वो मतलब पिता की तरफ भी होता है माता की तरफ भी होता है। तो यहाँ पे क्या हुआ था कि कश्यप मुनि के बहुत सारे पत्नियां थी, उनमें से एक पत्नी का नाम है दीति। सो दीति जो थी ना, वो शी वॉज नॉट ऑफ गुड डिस्पोजिशन, मतलब वो शी वॉज नॉट डिवोटी। सो इसके लिए दीति और कश्यप के जो पुत्र थे वो हिरण्यकश्यप हुई, ही वॉज अ डीमन। हाँ, ऑनलाइन कोई कुछ कह रहा था? ओके, पर हिरण्यकश्यपु और कयाडु के बेटे प्रहलाद, तो ये थोड़ा एक्सेप्शन केस है। प्रहलाद ने भी जब उनकी जो वाइफ थी शी वॉज अ डीमनस, इसके लिए उनके बेटे विरोचन हुए थे। अब विरोचन और इनके ये एक्चुअली ये थोड़ा एक्सेप्शन है, बट जनरली मतलब डीमन्स के बेटे डीमन ही होते हैं। बट वही है कि मतलब इससे ये पता चलता है कि ऐसा कोई जरूरी नहीं है कि पिता अगर डिवोटी है तो उनका बेटा भी डिवोटी होगा, मतलब इट ऑल्सो डिपेंड्स ऑन द स्पाउस, मतलब उनके वाइफ कैसी है उन पर भी डिपेंडेंस होता है। तो ये चीज हमें दिखता है यहाँ पे। और बाय द वे, मतलब ये हिरण्यकश्यपु से बलि महाराज तक ये सारे आसुर थे, दे आर ऑल आसुरास, लाइक डिस्पाइट बीइंग बोर्न इन आसुर फैमिली, प्रहलाद एंड बलि महाराज बोथ आर डिवोटीज। और दोनों इनफैक्ट मतलब दे आर नॉट जस्ट ऑर्डिनरी डिवोटीज, दे आर महाजन। महाजन मतलब सबसे उच्च डिवोटी थे, इसलिए उनके बारे में हम स्टडी कर रहे हैं। सो अभी हम देखते हैं स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ यूनिवर्स के बारे में। तो ब्रह्मांड जो है, ब्रह्मांड को ब्रह्मांड इसलिए कहते हैं कि वो ओवल शेप का होता है। तो इसमें आप देखिए हमारा जो अर्थ है वो एकदम सेंटर में आता है, तो इसको भूलोका बोलते हैं। भूलोका इसलिए बोलते हैं क्योंकि इसमें सारे अर्थली प्लैनेट्स आते हैं, नॉट जस्ट अर्थ, अर्थ के साथ दूसरे जो भी प्लैनेट्स हैं जो अर्थ के डायमेंशन में वो आते हैं। अच्छा, हम स्वर्ग लोक बोलते हैं, स्वर्ग लोक को इंग्लिश में अगर ट्रांसलेट करूँ तो इट्स एक्चुअली अपर प्लैनेटरी सिस्टम। अपर प्लैनेटरी मतलब यहाँ से ऊपर। तो ये सारे स्वर्ग लोक के प्लैनेट्स हैं, भूवर लोक, स्वर्ग लोक, महालोक, जनलोक, तपलोक, सत्यलोक। सत्यलोक इज द प्लैनेट ऑफ लॉर्ड ब्रह्मा, ब्रह्मा जी यहाँ पे रहते हैं। और अगर अर्थ के आप नीचे जाओगे तो दीज आर लोअर प्लैनेटरी सिस्टम्स, अताल, अभिताल, सुताल, तलाताल, महाताल, रसताल, पाताल। पाताल लोगों ने सुना रहेगा, पाताल मतलब हेल जनरली बोलते हैं उसे। सो दीज आर द लोअर प्लैनेटरी सिस्टम्स। तो जो भी देवताज थे वो यहाँ पे रहते थे, जितने भी देवताज है ये अपर प्लैनेटरी सिस्टम में रहते हैं, और जितने भी आसुर है दे स्टे इन द, आसुर और नाग जो भी है दे स्टे इन द लोअर प्लैनेटरी सिस्टम, और हम मनुष्य जो है वो भूलोक में रहते हैं। सो ये भूलोक जो है ये इट्स लाइक अ क्रॉसिंग, मतलब आपकी आप इसे बहुत सारे रास्ते एक जगह पे मिलते हैं, तो वहां से आपको कहाँ जाना है, आपको लेफ्ट जाना है, राइट जाना है, सीधा जाना है। सो इट्स लाइक दिस, ये मतलब यहाँ पे आए तो मतलब आप जीरो पे हो। तो यहाँ से इफ यू डू गुड कर्मा यू गो अप, इफ यू डू बैड कर्मा यू गो डाउन, लाइक दिस। तो ये स्ट्रक्चर है यूनिवर्स का। ये कौन है, कोई गेस करना चाहेगा? क्लोज है, मतलब आई ओनली टेल ये बृहस्पति है। सो बृहस्पति इज द गुरु ऑफ द देवास। बृहस्पति एक प्लैनेट भी है, कौन सा प्लैनेट है कोई बता सकता है? हाँ, जुपिटर। यस यस, जुपिटर, थैंक यू। ये कौन है? ये एक हिंट देता हूँ, मतलब शुक्राचार्य। सो शुक्राचार्य इज द गुरु ऑफ द आसुरास। तो ये दोनों पोलर ऑपोजिट्स है, बृहस्पति इज ऑन साइड वन साइड, शुक्राचार्य इज ऑन अदर साइड। शुक्र भी एक प्लैनेट है, कौन से प्लैनेट है कोई बता सकते? हाँ, वीनस, वेरी गुड। तो अब क्या हो रहा था कि मतलब द देवास यूज टू फॉलो देयर गुरु एंड दानवास एंड द दैत्यास यूज टू फॉलो देयर ओन गुरु, बट व्हाट हैपेंड इज दैट द देवास वर नॉट लिसनिंग टू देयर गुरु। मतलब इंद्र को अहंकार हो गया था, ही वॉज नॉट प्रॉपरली रिस्पेक्टिंग हिज गुरु, वॉज नॉट फॉलोइंग द इंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ हिज स्पिरिचुअल मास्टर। ऑन द अदर एंड असुरास दे वर ओबेइंग देयर गुरु वेरी डिलीजेंटली, मतलब गुरु की जो भी आदेश थे वो बहुत ही अच्छे से पालन कर रहे थे, बहुत ही अच्छे से फॉलो कर रहे थे। तो फिर क्या हुआ, इसका नतीजा क्या हुआ कि जब युद्ध हुआ मतलब देवास और असुरास का, तो देवता लोग जीतने या हार गए। क्यों हार गए? वो उनके गुरु महाराज को प्लीज नहीं कर पाए, वो गुरु महाराज की बातें नहीं सुन रहे थे। ऑन द अदर एंड असुर लोग, दो दे आर लोअर एंटिटीज, उनके पास उतना पावर्स नहीं है, बिकॉज दे वर फॉलोइंग देयर स्पिरिचुअल मास्टर एज इट इज, दे वर एबल टू डिफीट द देवास। एंड हु वाज द किंग ऑफ असुरास एट दैट टाइम? वाज महाराज बलि, बलि महाराज। हाँ, बलि महाराज। सो बलि महाराज ही बिकेम द किंग ऑफ द थ्री वर्ल्ड्स आफ्टर डिफीटिंग ऑल द देवास। सो नाउ व्हाट हैपेंड, बलि महाराज ऑफ कोर्स दो ही वाज अ असुर, ही वाज एक्चुअली वेरी पायस, मतलब काफी अच्छे प्रवृत्ति के थे, बट अनफॉर्चुनेटली उनके साथ जो उनके जनरल्स थे, उनके जो दूसरे प्रजा थी, वो आसुरिक प्रवृत्ति के थे। तो द आसुरास, जैसे ही आसुर लोग जीतते हैं, दे स्टार्टेड हैरेसिंग द ब्राह्मणास, द वैष्णवस एंड एवरीथिंग। सो जैसे ही बलि महाराज का मतलब जीत गए, तीनों लोग जीत गए, ही स्टार्टेड हैरेसिंग एवरीवन, लाइक ही स्टार्टेड हैरेसिंग द ब्राह्मणास, हैरेसिंग द वैष्णवस एंड एवरीवन। Prahlad Maharaj. Yes, yes, he is the grandson of Prahlad Maharaj. So Bali Maharaj was good, but he is the king of Asuras. Asuras are not good. So when Asuras become dominant, they started harassing all the devotees and the Vaishnavas. This is what happens. So jab Bali Maharaj, when he won the three worlds, all these Asuras, they become dominant. They started harassing the Brahmanas. So looking at all this, someone became very unhappy. So यहाँ पे लाइक वी आर गोइंग टू एक्सप्लोर कि कश्यप मुनि का मतलब फैमिली हिस्ट्री कैसा है। सो कश्यप मुनि हैड मेनी वाइफ्स, सो वन ऑफ दी वाइफ वॉज अदिति, अनदर वाइफ वॉज दीति, अनदर वाइफ वॉज दानु। सो अदिति के जितने भी संतान थे दे आर ऑल नोन एज देवास। देवास मतलब देवता जो भी है, इंद्र, चंद्र वगैरह जो भी देवता है, They are the sons of Kashyap and Aditi. And Kashyap and Diti, इनके जो बेटे थे ये सब दैत्य थे. And Kashyap and Danu, इनके जो बेटे थे सारे दानवास थे.
लेकिन दैत्य जो हिरण्यकश्यप हाँ, but what दानवास?
दानवास मतलब ऐसे बहुत फेमस दानवास आए थे, don't know, but दैत्य दानवास दोनों they are असुरी. मतलब उनका प्रवृत्ति बहुत खराब है. जितने फेमस लोग हैं सारे वो दैत्य ही है मोस्टली. हिरण्यकश्यप जो भी है, मतलब हिरण्यकश्यप, हिरण्याक्ष और वानासुर, दे आर ऑल दैत्यस, उसी लाइन में आते हैं. बट लाइक दीज टू आर डेमोनाइट और ये जो है दे आर डिवोटीज, दे आर डेमिगॉड्स. उनका नेचर मतलब कश्यप मुनि वॉज अ वेरी वेरी पायस डिवोटी, ही वॉज अ डिवोटी, बट अदिति वॉज ऑल्सो अ डिवोटी, दीति एंड डानु वर नॉट. सो इसलिए उनके जो संतान थे मतलब वो उनके माता के स्वभाव पे गए. तो ये हमने स्टार्टिंग में डिस्कस किया था जब हम ये फैमिली ट्री देख रहे थे. तो फैमिली ट्री जब मैं दिखा रहा हूँ, वापस आके दिखा देता हूँ यहाँ पे. हाँ, तो यहाँ पे कैसे थे, कश्यप के बेटे हिरण्यकश्यप, ही वॉज अ डीमन. हिरण्यकश्यप के बेटे प्रहलाद, प्रहलाद वॉज अ डिवोटी. प्रहलाद के बेटे विरोचन, ही वॉज अगेन अ डीमन. विरोचन के बेटे बलि महाराज, ही वॉज अ डिवोटी. तो ये इसलिए हुआ क्योंकि उनके माता का जो स्वभाव था ना वो उनके बेटे को मिला ऐसा वो. सो द नेचर ऑफ द चाइल्ड ऑल्सो डिपेंड्स ऑन लाइक बोथ दी स्पाउसेस, नॉट जस्ट द फादर.
तो प्रहलाद महाराज दो इज अ डिवोटी बट ही इज अ ही फ्रॉम द Rakshas.
Yeah, there was a reason for that. I will not go into that past time. There was a reason why Prahlad Maharaj is born to Hiranyakashipu. So, it is like an exception. But Prahlad Maharaj, he was such a dedicated devotee, yet his son was a demon. So, that was because his wife was a demon. Yeah, so coming back to this family tree. So what happened is after the Daityas and Danavas, they started ruling the three worlds. Aditi became very unhappy because her sons were not being respected anymore. Aur matlab Brahmanas ko bhi kafi attachar kar rahe the Daityas and Danavas. So Aditi was not happy. So Aditi is the mother of the Devas and she became very unhappy after the Danavas took over all the three worlds. So she started praying to the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Started doing a lot of austerities. And then the Supreme Personality of Godhead, he came in front of Aditi after being pleased with her austerities. And what did he say? The Supreme Personality of Godhead promised to be born as a son. मतलब उन्होंने उनको वचन दिया कि मैं आपका बेटा होके आऊंगा and I will इंश्योर कि आपके जो बेटे हैं वो वापस राज करने लग जाए तीनों लोगों पर. ये उन्होंने अश्योरेंस दिया. फिर उन्होंने कौन सा अवतार दिया, कोई बताना चाहेगा? वामन देव अवतार. सो वामन देव अवतार अगर किसी ने फोटो देखा होगा बताता हूँ मैं आगे.
बलि राजा का
हाँ आगे आएगा. सो अभी बलि महाराज ही बिकेम द एम्परर ऑफ ऑल द थ्री वर्ल्ड्स. ही वाज परफॉर्मिंग अ सैक्रिफाइस. सो जनरली मतलब ये जो यज्ञ करते हैं, मतलब कोई भी अगर यज्ञ कर रहा है, दे आर अल्टीमेटली ट्राइंग टू अचीव समथिंग इवन ग्रेटर, राइट? सो कोई मटेरियल बेनिफिट के लिए मोस्टली यज्ञ कर देते हैं असुरस. सो ही वाज परफॉर्मिंग अ वेरी बिग यज्ञ. सो यज्ञ के बीच में सडनली ब्राह्मणा के, हु इज दिस ब्राह्मणा? बलि महाराज जो वॉज असुर, ही वॉज एक्चुअली अ वेरी सेंटली किंग. सो वेन एवर एनी ब्राह्मण इज टू अप्रोच हिम, ही वुड ऑलवेज रिस्पेक्ट हिम and honor him. So immediately got up and started honoring Vamandev. So he started worshipping very respectfully. This is the wife of Bali Maharaj. Her name is Vidyavali. So both are worshipping Vamandev. Now as they are worshipping, so it's a custom ki jab bhi hum brahman ko वर्शिप करते हैं, वी शुड नॉट लेट देम गो एम्प्टी हैंडेड. लाइक इफ दे कम वी हैव टू गिव देम समथिंग. सो बलि महाराज ही आस्क हिम लाइक आपको क्या चाहिए, व्हाट डू यू वांट टू गिव मी, टू गिव यू एज अ भिक्षा. सो देन वामन देट सेड कि आई जस्ट वांट 3 steps ऑफ लैंड मेजर्ड बाय मी. तो ये सुन के ही मतलब बलि महाराज ही स्टार्टेड लाफिंग. सो ही वॉज सेइंग दैट दिस ब्राह्मण इज ऑलरेडी लाइक दिस शॉर्ट, ही इज जस्ट अ ड्वार्फ. सो इफ ही इज आस्किंग 3 steps इट्स लाइक लिटिल बिट. एंड बलि महाराज इज लाइक एन ओशन. सो बलि महाराज ने उनको कहा कि आप छोटे हो, आप बच्चे हो, आपको पता नहीं, आप सागर के पास आके आप कुछ बूंद मांग रहे हो, तो यू शुड आस्क मी समथिंग मोर, मतलब कुछ और मांगो मेरे से, कि और कुछ ज्यादा मांगो. बट वामन देव वॉज वेरी स्मार्ट, ही सेड कि नहीं, आई वॉन्ट ओनली दीज 3 things, लाइक 3 steps मेजर्ड बाय मी, मुझे इतना ही चाहिए, आई विल बी वेरी हैप्पी टू गिव मी दैट. सो बलि महाराज सेड ओके. जैसे उन्होंने ओके बोला, सो हु इज द गुरु महाराज ऑफ बलि?
शुक्राचार्य.
हाँ, शुक्राचार्य द गुरु महाराज ऑफ द दैत्यज एंड दानवास. सो ही इमीडिएटली कॉशनड हिम. तो शुक्राचार्य व्हाट डिड ही से, दैट दिस बॉय इज नो अदर देन लॉर्ड विष्णु एंड ही हैज कम टू डिप्राइव यू ऑफ ऑल योर वेल्थ एंड पोजिशन. सो इमीडिएटली शुक्राचार्य केम एंड ही वॉर्न्ड हिम कि ये जो लड़का है, ही हैज नॉट कम टू गिव यू एनी बेनिडिक्शन, वो आया है तुमसे सब कुछ छीन लेने के लिए. तो बलि महाराज थॉट फॉर सम टाइम एंड देन व्हाट डिड ही से, एंड हाउ कैन आई अ ग्रैंडसन ऑफ प्रह्लाद गो बैक ऑन माई वर्ड. मतलब मैंने ऑलरेडी प्रॉमिस कर दिया उन्हें कि आई एम गोइंग टू गिव यू, जो भी आपने प्रॉमिस किया है वो मैं देने वाला हूँ, देन हाउ कैन आई गो बैक. तो तब शुक्राचार्य ने बोला कि आपने ऐसे ही मतलब यू जस्ट मेड अ स्टेटमेंट. जब तक आप मतलब वो बोल के, मतलब पहले के जमाने में ऐसे प्रथा होती थी कि वेन यू प्रॉमिस समथिंग टू ब्राह्मणा, यू हैव टू प्रॉमिस एंड देन पोर वाटर, मतलब उनको उनके उनको दो मतलब हाथ पैर धोने के. हाँ, तो जब तक वो ना करो, आपने जो प्रॉमिस किया है वो मतलब प्रॉमिस माना नहीं जाता. तो उन्होंने बोला कि आपने सिर्फ ऐसे बोला है, अभी तक वो किया नहीं है, तो अभी अब वापस जा सकते हो. बट स्टिल लाइक बलि महाराज ही वॉज वेरी स्ट्रॉन्ग, लाइक ही सेड कि एक बार मैंने बोल दिया है, वंस आई हैव प्रॉमिस टू अ ब्राह्मणा देन आई विल डू इट लाइक वॉट एवर इट इज. सो व्हाट डिड ही से दैट, आई डू नॉट फियर हेल, poverty and ocean of distress, fall down from my position or even death itself, as much as I fear cheating a brahmana. So that was his position. He was like very truthful, very much like once he gives a word, he will do it. So he told that I do not fear anything, but I fear cheating a brahmana or like becoming infamous for that. So then he also gave instructions to Shukracharya. So what did he say that? Previously when I was performing sacrifices, so used to offer oblations to Lord Vishnu. तो तभी तो आपने रोका नहीं मुझे, but why are you stopping me now? Why are you stopping me from doing all this right now? Just because like earlier Lord Vishnu used to become happy and used to give me some benefits, and now he has come with some other intention, he is stopping me. That's not good. That's what he said. So then Shukracharya. Then he told Shukracharya, I will offer Lord Vishnu whatever he wants, regardless of whether he has come as a friend or as an enemy. I am going to offer him everything. So after this, he started pouring the water for washing the hands of Vamandev. So Shukracharya, though he was a spiritual master, but he was a materialistic spiritual master. So the reason behind Shukracharya warning Bali Maharaj was that because if Bali Maharaj का जो पैसा है लाइक इफ इट गोज अवे देन शुक्राचार्य को कौन मेंटेन करेगा. उनका ये मेंटेलिटी था कि वो सोच रहे थे कि मतलब अगर बलि महाराज का सब चले जाएगा तो मुझे कौन देखेगा, ऐसा था. बट अ ट्रू स्पिरिचुअल मास्टर इज नॉट लाइक दैट. अ ट्रू स्पिरिचुअल मास्टर विल ऑलवेज गिव द राइट इंस्ट्रक्शंस. मतलब वो ऐसा कभी नहीं सोचेंगे कि मतलब कोई मटेरियल बेनिफिट नहीं होते एक ट्रू स्पिरिचुअल मास्टर वैसे होते. So what he did is he became a small bee and he went over there and stopped the water from falling. So Vamandev, when he saw this, like he took a blade of grass and he poked into the hole and it pierced the eye of that bee. And from that day, Shukracharya became one-eyed because one of his eyes became blind. And he immediately went away and the water started pouring into the hands of Vamandev.
So that bee was Shukracharya.
Yes, the bee was Shukracharya. Now, as the water was falling into the hands and feet of Vamandev, Vamandev began growing and growing in stature. So, वो इतने बड़े हो गए कि पूरा यूनिवर्स उनके सामने छोटा लगने लग गया, इतने वो बड़े हो गए. And when he expanded into that form, then he started measuring the entire universe with his feet. So, एक पैर से उन्होंने पूरा भूलोक माप लिया, दूसरे पैर से उन्होंने पूरा जो हेवनली प्लैनेट्स है पूरा माप लिया, और उनका पैर इनफैक्ट सत्यलोक तक चले गया था. तो इफ यू रिमेंबर द चार्ट जो मैंने स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ यूनिवर्स बताया था, सबसे जो टॉप मोस्ट प्लैनेट है दैट इज सत्यलोक वेयर लॉर्ड ब्रह्मा स्टेज. सो उन्होंने पूरा मतलब अर्थ एंड लोअर प्लैनेटरी सिस्टम एक पैर से माप लिया, और दूसरे पैर से पूरा जो बीच मतलब जो भी हेवनली प्लैनेट सारे माप लिए, और उनका बॉडी बाकी जो बीच में का स्पेस है वो सारा ऑक्यूपाई कर लिया. तो इन शॉर्ट जो तीन लोग के मालिक थे, ही बिकेम लाइक ऑलमोस्ट लाइक अ बेगर, ही लॉस्ट एवरीथिंग विद इन टू स्टेप्स. बट फिर भी उनका जो प्रॉमिस दिया था वो पूरा नहीं हुआ, बिकॉज ही वॉज आस्किंग फॉर थ्री स्टेप्स, उन्होंने टू स्टेप्स ही दिया था. फिर जब ये सेकेंड स्टेप ले रहे थे, सो वॉट हैपेंड इज दैट दिस यूनिवर्स इट्स लाइक अ एग, इट्स लाइक अ शेल. सो उसका भी एक आउटर कवर है, तो वहां पे उनका है ना टोनेल लग गया था, तो वहां पे एक मतलब छेद हो गया था, एक टाइप का सा जब क्रैक हो गया था ना वैसा हो गया था. तो उसके बाहर जो वाटर है मतलब एक बहुत ही पवित्र वाटर रहता है वहां पे, तो वो वहां से निकल गया. और ये जो पानी है ये एक्चुअली गंगा माता है. सो दैट्स हाउ गंगा माता एक्चुअली एंटर्ड इन टू आर यूनिवर्स. एंड इनिशियली शी वेंट टू ब्रह्मा लोका, एंड फ्रॉम ब्रह्मा लोका शी केम डाउन टू द अर्थ through the penances of Bhagirath Muni. And वो जब अर्थ में आए थे तब शिव जी ने उनको अपने जटाओं में बांध के रख दिया था, और फिर उनके जटा से गंगा नदी निकली. सो गंगा इज एनी वे इट्स वेरी गंगा इज वेरी प्योर, बट शी बिकम्स इवन मोर प्योर बिकॉज शी कम्स फ्रॉम द लोटस फीट ऑफ द लॉर्ड हिमसेल्फ, एंड अगेन शी कम्स फ्रॉम द हेड ऑफ लॉर्ड शिवा, दैट्स व्हाई शी बिकम्स मोर प्योर. So Vamandev covered the entire three worlds with two steps. दो steps से उन्होंने पूरा तीनों जो लोक है वो cover कर लिया. फिर उन्होंने पूछा कि third step के लिए जगह ही नहीं है, आपने मुझे promise किया था कि तीन step दोगे, तो third step कहाँ पर रखो? तो तभी ये कौन है? कोई बता दो. हाँ. So Garuda is the like the servant of Lord. He's always there. तो गरुड़ जी ने भी देखा कि मतलब apparently ऐसा लग रहा था कि बलि महाराज cheated him, like cheated Vamandev after promising three steps he gave only two. So he immediately came and he arrested बलि महाराज. तो उन्होंने arrest कर लिया. And he didn't arrest like in any ordinary fashion. He arrested him with the nooses of Varundev. So Varundev कौन है? Any idea? समुंदर के. So he's the demigod, like he's in charge of the water bodies and everything. So उनका जो weapon है it's the noose. Noose मतलब एक rope type है. तो वो अगर फेंकते हैं तो मतलब कोई उधर से निकल नहीं सकता. तो उन्होंने वरुण जी का rope लेके इनको बांध दिया और उनको पेश कर दिया वामनदेव के सामने. So of course बलि महाराज was feeling very insignificant कि उन्होंने एक promise किया था एक ब्राह्मण को पर वो पूरा नहीं कर पाए. So he hung his head in shame. फिर उनके जो ग्रैंडफादर थे प्रहलाद महाराज, दिस प्रहलाद महाराज, सो हिज ग्रैंडफादर आल्सो केम इन फ्रंट ऑफ एंड ही कुडंट एक्चुअली फेस द लॉर्ड ऑर द ग्रैंडफादर बिकॉज वो अपेरेंटली वो ही डिडंट फुलफिल द प्रॉमिस, व्हाटएवर प्रॉमिस ही गिव, ही वाज ही हंग हिज हेड इन लाइक हेड इन शेम. सो देन बलि महाराज कुछ प्रेयर्स बोलते हैं या फिर कुछ श्लोक्स हैं इन श्रीमद भागवतम विच आई वी आर गोइंग टू रीड. ठीक है, तो बलि महाराज क्या कहते हैं? O best personality of Godhead, most worshipful for all the demigods, if you think that my promise has become false, I shall certainly rectify matters to make it truthful. I cannot allow my promise to be false. Please therefore place your third lotus footstep on my head. तो क्या कहते हैं कि आपका जो तीसरा step है वो आप मेरे सिर पे रख दीजिए. तो अभी logically थोड़ा सोचिए, मतलब वामनदेव ने इतना बड़ा आकार लिया था कि एक एक स्टेप से उन्होंने पूरा धरती और जितने भी लोअर प्लेनेटरी सिस्टम है सब कवर कर लिया, दूसरे स्टेप से सारा हेवन कवर कर लिया। तो बलि महाराज इतने छोटे थे तो उनके सिर पे कैसे वो पैर रख सकते हैं? किसी के पास कोई गेस करना चाहेगा कैसे ये पॉसिबल है? लॉजिकल पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू दैट हाउ कैन ही प्लेस हिज थर्ड स्टेप ऑन सच अ स्मॉल हेड, लाइक हाउ इज इट पॉसिबल? यानी कोई भी कुछ कहना चाहे तो कह सकते हैं।
एक्चुअली दो ही स्टेप्स रहते हैं।
हाँ।
थर्ड स्टेप्स हाउ टू बिकम।
आई वाज वंडरिंग दिस फॉर अ लॉन्ग
टाइम। तो वो क्वेश्चन मुझे भी था।
धरती को मेजर करने के बाद वो भी आ गए। हाँ। बलि महाराज उसमें आ गए।
हाँ। तो बलि महाराज के ऊपर कैसा है? तो इसका एक एग्जांपल है, मतलब ये ही क्वेश्चन का अगर आप श्रीमद् भागवतम पढ़ोगे तो इन श्रीमद् भागवत ऑफ कोर्स एनीवन एज भगवत गीता एज इट इज, उसमें कैसे प्रभुपाद जी gives the translation, he gives a purport. In the purport is explaining this shlok ka meaning kya hai, iska significance kya hai. So if you read the purport of this particular shlok, Prabhupada ji has very beautifully explained one thing. So say for example, Rup ji aap le lo, samjho aapke paas 1 crore rupiah hai, theek hai, samajh vaise, theek hai. To aap bade ho ki 1 crore rupiah bada hai?
Main bada
hoon. Right? Kisi ko question hai isme? So the possessor of opulence is always bigger than the opulence. So Bali Maharaj, because he was the possessor of the three worlds, he is definitely bigger than the three worlds. So इसलिए उनके उनके सिर में उतना जगह था कि वो पैर रख पाए। तो ये बहुत सारे ऐसे questions हैं, बहुत सारे चीजें हैं जो हम logically नहीं समझ सकते, but only if we understand it from a proper spiritual master or proper acharya, we'll understand. So because Bali Maharaj was the owner of all the three worlds, he was bigger than the three worlds. That is why it is possible for Bhavandev to place the third step on his head. But वही है कि अगर साइज छोटा करके उन्होंने रख दिया होता तो वो प्रॉमिस फुलफिल नहीं होता, राइट? प्रॉमिस टूट जाता था, तो वो प्रॉमिस भी उन्होंने रखा एंड एट द सेम टाइम मतलब ये पॉसिबल है क्योंकि जो पोजेसर होता है इज बिगर देन द व्हाटएवर पोजीशन सी, सो इट्स लाइक दैट।
ओनली वन पर्सन आई रियलाइज लाइक बलि महाराज वेरी एंट्री डिवोटी देन व्हाई वाज पनिश्ड?
या इस ये भी आगे आएगा इन दिस सेशन ओनली। सो देन ही सेज द सेम थिंग दैट आई डू नॉट फियर बीइंग डिप्राइव्ड ऑफ ऑल माय पोजीशंस लिविंग इन हेलिश लाइफ बीइंग अरेस्टेड फॉर पॉवर्टी बाय द रोप्स ऑफ वरुणा और बीइंग पनिश्ड बाय यू एज मच आई फियर डिफेमेशन। तो उन्होंने क्लियरली बता दिया कि ही डजंट वांट टू बी डिफेम्ड, मतलब ही इज वेरी फेमस, हिज ग्रैंडफादर इज आल्सो वेरी फेमस, ग्रैंडफादर इज प्रहलाद महाराज, सो ही वांटेड टू मेंटेन दैट फेम दैट व्हाटएवर प्रॉमिस ही हैज गिवन ही विल फुलफिल इट। एंड इट्स एक्चुअली वेरी रेयर इन दिस एज ऑफ कलयुग, राइट? कि मतलब ऐसे मिलते नहीं हम लोग कि जो कुछ बोलते हैं वो करके दिखाते हैं, ऐसे जनरली लोग मिलते नहीं। इट्स एक्चुअली वेरी रेयर थिंग। बलि महाराज वाज लाइक एन पर्सनिफिकेशन ऑफ दैट कीपिंग वंस वर्ड। सिंस योर लॉर्डशिप इज इनडायरेक्टली द ग्रेटेस्ट वेल विशर ऑफ अस डीमंस, यू एक्ट फॉर आवर बेस्ट वेलफेयर बाय पोजिंग एज इफ आवर एनिमी। Because demons like us always aspire for a position of false prestige. By chastising us, you give us the eyes to see which is the right path. तो अभी बलि महाराज खुद बोल रहे कि ऐसे apparently देख के तो लग रहा है कि आपने punish कर दिया मुझे, but actually you are punishing for my own good. Because we are demons. Of course, बलि महाराज though he was born in a demon family, he was definitely not a demon. But still, his association was demonic. उनके जो ministers थे, उनकी जो family थी, they were all demons. तो अभी कीचड़ में रहोगे तो थोड़ा तो कीचड़ लग ही जाएगा, तो वैसे टाइप का था उनका। सो उन्होंने बोला कि लाइक यू पनिश मी, इट्स एक्चुअली लाइक अ मर्सी फॉर इट बिकॉज आप पनिश करके मुझे सही रास्ता दिखा रहे हो। माय ग्रैंडफादर प्रहलाद महाराज इज फेमस बीइंग रिकॉग्नाइज्ड बाय ऑल योर डिवोटीज, ऑल्दो हैरेस्ट इन मेनी वेज बाय हिज फादर हिरण्यकश्यपु, ही स्टिल रिमेन्ड फेथफुल टेकिंग शेल्टर एट योर लोटस फीट। सो प्रहलाद महाराज के बारे में तो मतलब लोगों ने सुना ही होगा या फिर पढ़ा होगा। प्रहलाद महाराज को काफी डिफिकल्टीज हुई थी उनके पिताजी के बारे में, उनके पिताजी ने उनको बहुत हैरेस किया था, बट स्टिल ही रिमेंड फेथफुल। और ये उनके ग्रैंडसन थे तो उन्होंने बोला कि आई विल ऑल्सो फॉलो द पाथ ऑफ माई ग्रैंड फादर। सो ही इमिजिएटली लाइक ही सरेंडर्ड हिज लाइफ एंड ही सेड कि इफ यू वॉन्ट टू आई विल अश्योर दैट मैंने जो भी बोला वो सच हो जाए, सो प्लीज प्लेस योर थर्ड स्टेप ऑन माई हेड। ही इमिजिएटली द लॉर्ड प्लेस्ड हिम ऑन हिज हेड एंड ही बलि महाराज ही सरेंडर्ड हिज लाइफ। सो आफ्टर दिस हैपेंड ऑफ कोर्स लाइक नोबडी लाइक पीपल वर लिटिल बिविल्डर्ड कि ऐसा क्यों किया भगवान ने, मतलब बलि महाराज सच अ ग्रेट डिवोटी, व्हाई डिड ही लाइक unnecessarily take away his possessions, why did he like take away his life. So in that assembly Prahlad Maharaj also there, so he also started saying that my lord, it is a lordship who gave this Bali the very great opulence of the post of heavenly king, and now today it is you who have taken it away. I think you have acted with equal beauty in both ways, because his exalted position as king of heaven was putting him in darkness of ignorance. You have done him a very merciful favor by taking away all his opulence. So यहाँ पे प्रहलाद महाराज क्या कह रहे हैं कि आपने ही आपके ही तो मर्सी से ही बिकेम दी किंग आफ्टर ऑल राइट, एंड अभी आपके मर्सी से ही लॉस्ट एवरीथिंग। Why he lost? And actually the Lord like he acted with equal beauty in both cases. ऐसा नहीं कि मतलब पहले जब राजा बना है तब वो मर्सीफुल थे, बाद में जब सब कुछ ले लिया तो ही वॉज नॉट मर्सीफुल, ही वॉज मर्सीफुल इन बोथ द केसेस। सो इन फर्स्ट केस लाइक ही वॉज रियली अ डिवोटी, बट कई बार ऐसा होता है कि आफ्टर वी गेन अ लॉट ऑफ मटेरियल वेल्थ और वी गेट अ लॉट ऑफ पोजिशन हमें अहंकार आ जाता है, वी हैव अ लॉट ऑफ फॉल्स ईगो, वी स्टार्टेड डूइंग ऑफेंसेस, वी स्टार्टेड थिंकिंग आवरसेल्फ एज ग्रेटर देन अदर्स। सो कई बार लोगों के साथ ऐसा होता है कि एक बार मतलब वंस यू बिकम ऑपुलेंट, एक बार पैसे आ जाते हैं तो ऐसा लगता है कि आई एम बेटर देन दी अदर्स, तो वो लॉर्ड डजंट लाइक इट। लॉर्ड ऑलवेज लाइक्स अ डिवोटी इज वेरी हम्बल, इज वेरी डाउन टू अर्थ, इज ऑलवेज रेडी टू सर्व हिम, सो दैट्स व्हाई ही टेक्स ही टुक अवे ऑल हिज ऑपुलेंस। देन लॉर्ड ब्रह्मा ऑल्सो सेड ओ वेल विशर एंड मास्टर ऑफ ऑल एविडेंटिस, ओ वर्शिपफुल डीटी ऑफ ऑल डेमिगॉड्स, ओ ऑल परवेटिंग पर्सनैलिटी ऑफ गॉडहेड, नाउ दिस मैन हैज बीन सफिशियंटली पनिश्ड, for you have taken everything, now you can release him, he does not deserve to be punished more. So Lord Brahma, Prahlad Maharaj, these are all great devotees the Lord, they are Mahajans. So devotee ke lakshan hota hai ki they don't like to see someone suffering, so they are pleading on the behalf of the Lord ki matlab aapne itna punish kiya, he doesn't deserve to be punished so much. Then Lord Brahma, what does he say? By offering even water, newly grown grass or flower buds at your lotus feet, those who maintain no mental duplicity can achieve the most exalted position within this spiritual world. तो क्या कहते हैं कि भगवान को खुश करने के लिए we don't have to be opulent, we don't have to be rich. अगर हम भगवान को पानी भी दे, grass भी दे या फिर flower buds भी दे, फिर भी अगर हम without any duplicity या without any मतलब क्या बोलते छल कपट के बिना अगर हम offer कर रहे हैं तो भगवान he becomes very happy and he gives us the topmost position in the spiritual world. This Bali Maharaj without duplicity has now offered everything in the three worlds. How can he deserve to suffer from arrest? तो यहाँ पे बता रहे कि Bali Maharaj has given you everything और ऐसे भी नहीं कि दिखावे के लिए दिया है, like he genuinely उन्होंने आपको सब कुछ दे दिया, how can he deserve to suffer from arrest? So everyone is pleading that ऐसा क्यों कर रहे हो बलि महाराज के साथ। तो then the Lord answers, भाई सबके questions answer होंगे जो कि why is he doing like this? Then the supreme personality of Godhead said, my dear Lord Brahma, because of material opulence, a foolish person becomes dull-witted and mad. तो यहाँ क्या कहते हैं कि एक बार मतलब लोगों को success मिलता है या फिर once they become materially very opulent, एक बार पैसे मिल जाते हैं या जो भी चाहिए वो मिल जाता है, then people become very dull-witted and mad. So this is very natural. बहुत सारे examples हैं in history also. Like once people gain wealth, they lose their intelligence. They started acting as if they are God. They become mad. Thus, he has no respect for anyone within the three worlds and defies even my authority. So ये भी होता है. To such a person, I show special favor by first taking away all his possessions. So this is what the Lord is saying, that जब कोई आदमी मतलब इफ समबडी कैन नॉट हैंडल लाइक सम डिवोटी ही हैज बिकम रिच ही कैन नॉट हैंडल द वेल्थ और द फेम देन आई शो अ स्पेशल फेवर बाय टेकिंग अवे ऑल दिस पोजीशंस सो दैट्स अ स्पेशल फेवर ऑफ द सुप्रीम पर्सनालिटी ऑफ गॉड सो बलि महाराज हैज नाउ बिकम द मोस्ट फेमस among the demons and non-believers. For in spite of being bereft of all material opulences, he is fixed in devotional service. So actually, it is not very easy, as you see. Like, kahi baar, like lot of people, they come to temple. Generally, people come to temple to gain something. Like, they might be studying, they want good marks, they want to get into good engineering college. Or if they are studying, they want to have good placement, they want to have good job. Or somebody, like they are searching for a girl or boy, they want to get married. So they all come with different intentions. So once they get what they want, then they stop it. And if they get, then they are happy. They say, Lord is so kind, Krishna is so kind, he's giving me everything. But if they don't get, or if they get something else, then immediately they become very angry that Lord is not listening to me, I'll not go to temple, there is no God or whatever. But Bali Maharaj is not like that. So when he was becoming opulent, he was a devotee. When he lost everything, and Lord himself came and deprived everything. He literally cheated him. But still he became more devotee. So that's a difference between a devotee and a normal person. A devotee will always see the hand of Krishna, either in opulence or in distress. And either opulence or distress, it will make him closer, come closer to Krishna. While on the other hand, a normal person, if everything is going good, then they will do bhakti, they will come to temple, they will do everything. But the moment things started going bad, they lose the faith. But Bali Maharaj was not like that. He was fixed in devotional service in spite of facing so many reversals. So here the Lord says that although bereft of his riches, fallen from his original position, defeated and arrested by his enemies, rebuked and deserted by his relatives and friends, although suffering the pain of being bound and although rebuked and cursed by spiritual master, Bali Maharaj, being fixed in his vow, did not give up truthfulness. It was certainly with pretension that I spoke about religious principles, but he did not give up the religious principles, for he is true to his word. So the Lord took the greatest test for Bali Maharaj. He lost everything, even his spiritual master like cursed him. And the Lord himself, the Bhagwan khud aake unke saath, he started talking in pretension. Matlab, janmuchke usko phasane ke liye, like he talked about some things, but he did not give up any religious principles because he was always true to his word.
There is one question, yeah. I doubt in text 24.
Yes.
Bali Maharaj never showed any arrogance.
Yeah.
He never expressed any kind of arrogance and everything.
Yes.
In spite of that, he was being punished.
No. So it's like this. If you read the purport of this, so you will understand. See, Prabhupada ji was also a very great devotee. So he was also similarly getting opulence and everything. But what happens is that, see, when a person is neophyte, matlab koi naya devotee hai, so initially to increase his faith on Krishna, like Krishna will give him everything, whatever he is asking. So that matlab agar wo aaya, matlab he is saying that I want better marks, I want better college, maybe he will get if he is also working in that direction. So what will happen is faith on Krishna will increase. So like this, like initial phases, when a devotee is like, initially in Krishna consciousness, they might get everything. But once they become very advanced, then what happens, all these material attachments and everything, they become like some kind of a chain, like it will pull them back. So then what the Lord does is, of course this doesn't happen to everyone, only for someone who is very highly elevated. Then the Lord will start taking away everything. So in case of Prabhupada also, this same happened. So Prabhupada ji, like when he was around like 50 years old, he was saying that suddenly, everything started going bad. Like Prabhupada was a very successful businessman. His business was in Allahabad, Calcutta, Mumbai. He used to travel places. Suddenly, his business was down. He was stolen in the shop. Then, मतलब इमीडिएटली मतलब एक साथ आ गया. सो देन प्रभुपाद रिमेंबर्ड हिज वर्स दैट इट इज एक्चुअली स्पेशल मर्सी ऑफ द लॉर्ड फॉर अ वेरी एडवांस डिवोटी. जो डिवोटी बहुत ज्यादा एडवांस्ड है, उनके सारे मटेरियल अटैचमेंट खत्म करने के लिए लॉर्ड टेक्स अवे एवरीथिंग, स्टार्ट्स टेकिंग अवे थिंग्स, सो दैट he loses interest in the material world and completely surrenders to the Lord. But this is only for those devotees who are very special to Lord. It's not given to everyone. And this is a very special mercy. Very few devotees realize it. Those who realize it, they will become like Bali Maharaj and they will get out of the cycle of birth and death. It's like that. So Bali Maharaj, yeah, you are correct. He didn't commit any offense as such. But because he was the king and he was a king of Asuras, he was getting that kind of association. It was impacting him. So the Lord took away everything. And he gave him a gift also, which we will see early, like in the later stage. Okay. So then the Lord said, the Lord continued, because of his great tolerance, I have given a place not obtainable even by the demigods. He will become king of heavenly planets during the period of Manu known as Savarni. So, अभी उन्होंने सारे material चीजें ले लिए, but उनको और ज़्यादा better position दिया. क्योंकि आप बोला कि in the next cycle, like in the Vedas, like there are cycles happening. We have a cycle of Shakti Yug, Treta Yug, Dwapar Yug, Kali Yug. So like these cycles happen. So the sequence of events keep on repeating. So like again a particular like set of cycles will become a man, like it's called a Manvantara avatar. Like so there is a cycle of one Manu. So I'll not go into details over there. But after such cycles, like the Indra also changes. Like abhi jo Indra hai, he's some person. But in the next cycle, the Indra would be Bali Maharaj. So Bali Maharaj will become the Indra in the next cycle.
So Indra is not the name of the person, but the name of the position.
Yeah, Indra is the name of the position. So the soul of Indra can change. The person who is Indra will change. It's like that.
So Sai, what is the Surya Sam? These are positions?
Yeah, these are positions.
All are positions.
Yeah. Of course, their lifetime is very, 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 very long. So for ours, like compared to our lifetimes, they are immortal. But again, like if we really see, they also have a lifetime and their position also changes.
Even Surya also changes?
Yeah. It's a post actually. Surya Dev is a post. The soul who is occupying the body of Surya will change. But it will take a lot of time. So Bali Maharaj, now... Yes. Yes.
In this image, we can see that, you know, as the size of the Lord increased, he almost covered the entire earth. So when you were trying to explain that logic, I had a question that if he has placed the feet on the earth, so earth is made up of all the living beings and the non-living beings. So even Maharaj gets covered. So then was he trying to place the feet on the ego, the subtle ego which, you know, people have?
Okay. First of all, these images, whatever you're seeing, these are representative images. They don't actually, because it's not possible to show that image in two dimensions, if you try to understand. So these images, whatever I'm showing, these are only for understanding purpose, only for illustration. That's the first point. Second thing is that, see, Bali Maharaj was the king of all the three worlds. So it's not that he was bound to earth. So when he covers the earth, like Bali Maharaj had access to heavens, he had access to the lower planetary systems, he had access to earth also. So he can travel everywhere and he can be in between also. It's like that. So when he places the like the feet on the earth, it's not that Bali Maharaj is also covered, because Bali Maharaj can actually travel anywhere. He had that opulence.
Thank you, Prabhuji.
Okay. So now Bali Maharaj was given a benediction that now you can go to the planet of Sutal. So Sutal, if you remember, like it is one of the lower planetary system, but actually it's not a, it's like a very beautiful planet. So what he says that it is desired even by demigods, like even the devtas who are staying in the upper planetary system, they desire to go to Sutal.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and live there peacefully, surrounded by your friends and relatives, all good fortune to you. So now we can see that, like apparently in like part one we were saying that the Lord is very much like harsh with Bali Maharaj, but now he is giving his mercy. So he gave him the benediction to go to Sutal planet, which is even better in terms of material opulence than the heavenly planets.
But generally they say that below the earth everything comes in the category of Narka.
No, it's not Narka. Again, it's a separate topic. Maybe like I will have to spend 15-20 minutes to explain that. we can have a separate session on that. It's not Narka, it's called lower binary system. It's called Bilaswarga. Bilaswarga means imitation heavens. So they are like heavens, but they are imitation heavens. I mean, in heaven, like everything is in the mode of goodness. In the Bilaswarga, everything is in the mode of ignorance. That's the difference. But in terms of material opulence, like the Bilaswarga planets are also equivalent, in fact, better than heavens. It's like that. So, O great hero, I shall always be by with you and give you protection in all respects, along with your associates and paraphernalia. Moreover, you will always be able to see me there. So, the Lord gave him benediction. And what is it? A benediction that I will be there personally. I will become your doorman. Now, can you imagine? Now, you are sitting over there and the Lord himself is standing at the door. And he is your doorman. He is protecting you. Can you imagine such a thing? Like, we are all aspiring to become servant of Krishna. And for Bali Maharaj, Krishna is serving him. He is serving, he is standing at the door with his Sudarshan Chakra.
And addressing him as a hero.
Yeah. So, you can see. So, whatever like problems we face, it's like a test. It's a test which is given by Krishna. If we pass it, then we'll get these kind of results. So, because there you will see my supreme prowess. Your materialistic ideas and anxieties that have arisen from an association with demons and danavas will immediately be vanquished. So you are very important, like your association. So because Bali Maharaj was born in a demonic family, he was always associating with demons. So whatever little bit of like demonic quality which he gets, like it will go away because he will be able to see the Lord directly. So that is like the story of Bali Maharaj. Now time for some reflection. So this battle was basically between Indra and Bali Maharaj. Okay. So what we saw is that Bali Maharaj defeated Indra. He became the king of the three worlds. But then Vaman Dev came and apparently he helped Indra regain his position and again to become the lord, right? The three worlds. So who do you think actually won between Indra and Bali?
Bali.
Why?
Because the Lord had to come to defeat the
demons. Yeah, but ultimately, like Indra got all the three worlds, right? So it should be Indra's victory. Bali Maharaj lost everything. Sorry?
Even
the God.
Even?
He won the God. Okay. Yeah, good answer. Okay, I'll just explain from the point of view of scripture. So Indra and Bali both are devotees, but both have different motivation. So Indra is like a devotee, he is doing devotion so that he becomes materially opulent, so that he becomes a king of all the three worlds, he becomes the supreme within this universe. That's his motivation for doing bhakti. On the other hand, Bali Maharaj is doing bhakti without any motivation. He also became the king of the three worlds, but he is doing bhakti without any motivation, without any self interest or anything. So ultimately what happened is Indra got what he wanted and Bali Maharaj also got what he wanted. But the thing which Bali Maharaj got, that is far, far, far more rare, far more valuable, because he is getting direct association of Lord. The Lord is standing as the doorman. You can try and understand, like Lord has become his servant, and on the other hand, Indra, like he's still the emperor of the three worlds and is enjoying whatever he thinks is good. So in our life also this happens many times. Like we hear questions like, why bad things happen to good people, or why good people are not able to like do well in life or whatever. The reason like why we get such questions is because we don't know the entire perspective. Over here also, like as Prabhuji had questioned, and I'm sure most of you must have questioned, like if you see the first half of the events, so everyone must have thought that Bali Maharaj was such a good person. Like why was the Lord cheating him? Like he's such a good person and bad things are happening to him. But we don't know the second half, what is happening. Like after they get what they get, then what is happening? So they were, that is not there, right? So if we know the entire picture, then only we will understand. that who has won, who has not won. So in this case, like Bali Maharaj won. So that's for the session today. Any questions or comments, feel free to ask.
Prahlad Maharaj is also an Asura.
Prahlad Maharaj is born in an Asuric family. So if you say the word Vasur, if you are saying this, anyone born in an Asura family is an Asura, then you can say that. But to call Prahlad an Asura is again would be a very great offense. He was born in an Asuric family, we always say that. Similarly, like whenever we are referring to Ashwatthama is always said he is a son of a Brahmana. We don't call him a Brahmana because he didn't have Brahmana qualities. Ravan, his father was a Brahman. But we never call him Brahman because he doesn't have Brahmanic qualities. So he is the son of a Brahman. So similarly, Prahlad Maharaj is the son of an Asura. He was born in the Asura, but he was not an Asura.
Your essence defined
over
here.
Yeah, so our qualities, our gunas define what we are. It's not our birth. It's not where we are born or in what kind of circumstance we are born. It's how we do with whatever things we are, which defines us, who we are.
Individual goon is necessary.
Sorry?
Individual goon is necessary.
Yeah. Our goonas are necessary. Yes?
So the Vamana avatar came later, Narasimha avatar.
Yes. Narasimha avatar interacted with Prahlad Maharaj. Narasimha Dev, he killed Hiranyakashipu and he blessed Prahlad Maharaj to become the king of the Asuras.
There was one more Asura called Hiranyakashipu.
Hiranyakashipu was the brother of Hiranyakashipu. He was killed by Varahavatar. Varahavatar came before Narasimha Dev.
Okay. Yeah. So the Hiranyakashipu and Hiranyakashipu were the rebirth of the Dwarpals of Brahma.
Yes, Maharaj. Yes. So,
Jai Vijay.
So that's again a big pastime. So it's like Jai Vijay, they were the Dwarpals, they were Vishnu Dutas. They were like doormen of Lord Vishnu. But they had been cursed by the four Kumaras to be born as Asuras. So in their first birth, they were born as Hiranyakashipu and Hiranyaksha. And they were liberated by the Lord himself in the form of Varaha and Narasimha Dev. In the second birth, they took birth as Ravana and Kumbhakaran. And they were liberated by Lord Ramchandra. In the third birth, they came as Shishupal and Dantavakra. And they were liberated by Lord Krishna. So that's why we always say that when Lord Krishna kills someone, then that person attains liberation. But that may or may not be true in case of other incarnations. So in other incarnations that happens, but here this is the final kind of an example where we can see like Krishna, when he kills someone, then they get liberation. But in case of other incarnations, they might get liberation, they may not also. That there is a small possibility they may not also in these cases.
But in case of Hiranyaksha and Hiranyakashipu, once they are liberated again by the born with the Ravana and
Yeah, it is like a pastime of Lord only. Normally it doesn't happen. From Vaikuntha planets, nobody falls down. And they didn't even do any kind of fault, to be honest. Like, the Lord didn't want anyone to go and meet him, and these four Kumaras, they went and they wanted to meet him immediately. They told him to wait and they cursed him. So it's like the mercy of Lord only. The Lord sometimes he desires to come down in this material world and he wants to fight someone. So who better to fight than his own devotees, right? So it's like a sport. So the Lord Krishna, like, of course he didn't fight, but he was in the opposite side of Bhishma. So Bhishma was shooting arrows at him. It was hurting Lord Krishna. But Lord Krishna was actually feeling pleasure. He was not feeling any pain. It's written in the Bhagavatam that Lord Krishna was enjoying transcendental pleasure when the arrows were hitting him, because he wanted that fighting spirit also, and who better to fight than his own devotee. So Bhishma was actually giving him pleasure. Similarly, all these Danavas, Ravan, Kumbhakaran, they are Vishnu's das only. So that's again a very, if you go into that, it will become very much complicated. But it's like a pastime of Lord. Something happened, I don't remember the past time. Something happened with them. Yes, yes. It was a mistake for them, and I think they something happened. I had read somewhere, but I don't remember the past time. So I wouldn't be able to say. Any other questions? Okay. Okay, if everything is done, then we have an announcement. So, Mahipal, would you like to announce that? Okay, I'll do that. So, how many of you have heard about Neelachal Vedic Village?
Yesterday I saw the video.
Okay.
In YouTube.
So, what is that? Can you tell me?
That Jagannath temple over there.
Hmm.
And Gausara.
Okay. So basically, if I want to like explain this in short, no, I don't have the video right now, but I'll just explain in short. So our Varnashram system or whatever has been prescribed by our acharyas, like we are supposed to live close to the nature. Our bodies are made in such a way, and if you want to also practice devotion really well, the devotional service really well, then we should be closer to nature. So that's why Neelachal Vedic Village has been like formed by our ISKCON Jew temple, so that we people staying in Mumbai, we can go over there and practice devotion service as desired by our acharyas. So over there, like we have a couple of core values, like we are living, like it's a very good eco village kind of a thing. So where everything is grown naturally. So there is no dependence on something outside. It's like a model where they have created, like everything is grown there and they consume it there itself. So there is no dependence on outside world. It's a very unique model. The core values are like the scripture are the basis. So whatever is done over there is on the basis of scriptures like Bhagavad Gita and Srimad Bhagavatam. Purity is the force. So whoever are residing over there, so there are ashrams over there, like there is. So what are the four ashrams? Can anyone say?
Ashram.
So we have Brahmacharya ashram, we have Grihastha ashram, we have Vanaprastha, and we have Sannyas. So it's actually a very logical explanation. Like it's like if somebody is living 100 years, so initial 25 years they have to be a Brahmachari. Brahmachari means a student. So they are learning, so they have to be austere, they have to follow rules and regulations, they have to learn scriptures. Then next 25 years they are supposed to get married and enter into household life. So that's called Grihastha ashram. After that, like when they are nearing 50 years of age, then they have to prepare themselves for completely concentrating their life on devotional service. So they take Vanaprastha ashram. Vanaprastha ashram is like they will leave their home and along with their wife they will go to the forest or some holy place and reside over there and take the names of the Lord. They perform devotional service. And in the last 25 years, like they will take sannyas. So sannyas is actually quite difficult. That's why it takes so much of time. Like after 75 years, then they are supposed to cut all their material attachment to everything and focus their life completely to service of Krishna. So it's like a very it was a very beautiful system which was there, but we have unlearned. So that is something which is being implemented over there. So
what is the difference
and Vanaprastha? A sannyasi is the main difference is sannyasi is not supposed to keep any contact with any of his family members, including wife. It's like that. And in Vanaprastha, they can live with their wives. That's the difference with Vanaprastha and sannyas. And sannyas, of course, like it's a very big responsibility.
So wife also will become sannyasini.
Sorry?
Wife also will become sannyasini.
No, wife doesn't become. It's like it's a very difficult thing. Okay. To be honest, in Kali Yuga, it's very difficult to become a sannyasi. So the people in our temple, those who are in saffron, they are actually brahmacharis. Lot of people think they are sannyasis, but most of them are brahmacharis. Sannyasis.
No, I mean, even the scripture, the husband becomes sannyas.
Yeah.
What about the wife?
Yeah. wife will be like, she will continue like, because to be honest, for a woman it's very difficult to stay alone in forest. It's very difficult, so it's not recommended also. So there is no sannyas principle for them. For them it's vanaprastha.
What will she do? I mean, she will come back to
Yeah, we can have a discussion on that. For now, let's talk about this. So these are the four ashrams, and these have been implemented like in a real life in Talashri farm. So we can see all these things, like whatever we learn from Bhagavad Gita in real life, that how to we live, like simple living and high thinking. So all the people living over there, that they are highly educated. There is a proper ashram for Grihastha, proper ashram for Brahmachari. And there are like facilities also, like it's a village style temple, like which has been made from mud. Then there is a very, very nice holistic cow care over there. So you find lot of beautiful cows over there, all the Gir cows mostly from Gujarat, and there are a lot of Maharashtrian cows also. Then you will find like lot of cow products, and using the cows, like they are making a lot of good products. If you go to the like temple, whatever products we are getting, that's coming from that farm only. There is a lot of natural chemical free farming. So whatever farming is happening over there, that's like completely natural without any fertilizer. And you will find a lot of biodiversity, different types of fruits, trees, flowers, vegetables. There is an ashram, and there is a very good like facility for taking prasadam. And then like there is a biogas and a solar plant also for generating electricity. So it's like that, you are getting to experience the nature, and at the same time you don't have to live in an austere environment. Like there is a very modern guest house over there, where the rooms are like very opulent, there is a swimming pool, and at the same time like you can stay in a very, very natural way. So it's a like a blessing for people like us who stay in Mumbai, who can't actually go and stay in villages. So for us, there are very beautiful guest house anyway, and there is a village next to it, and very opulent, like very good farm community. So that's a Nilachal Vedic village. So there are this you can say this is our temple, and there is a lot of greenery. And then we also do a nature walk over there to see how farming is carried out, how the different kinds of trees are made and everything. A lot of things are there. And you also see like different varieties of fruits, vegetables and everything. Typically we people who are born and brought up in Mumbai, we don't know a lot of vegetables, a lot of fruits. You can see it over there. So it will be a very exciting journey. So if we are planning to go over there on 26th and 27th. So 26th and 27th is Saturday, Sunday. So we leave Saturday morning and come back to Mumbai by Sunday night. So nobody will have to take any leave or anything. So if anyone is interested, you can give your names to Mahipal Prabhu. Mahipal Prabhu is maybe you can raise your hand. So he's over there. So, and we also have some very limited seats. So if anyone really wants to there, I would advise you to pay the booking amount at least, and maybe the remaining principal you can pay later on. But it would be a very good experience for everyone. Any questions regarding this?
Where is it?
This is near Palghar. So it's almost at the border of Maharashtra and Gujarat. It's Talashri, yeah. So the Talashri farm, it's known as Nilachal Vedic village. Have you gone over there?
I was confused. Once I went there, they took all of us on that particular day when the Krishna becomes covered boy.
Yeah, yeah. So a lot of festivals also happen over there.
It's the same place.
Yeah, it's the same place. So if anybody wants to come, then please let us know.
How is the total experience, sir?
Mahipal Prabhu will tell you everything. Can contact us. Okay. Any questions regarding this? Okay. Mahipal Prabhu.
Means that you close now. For 2 days you need to carry all this thing.
Yeah, you can carry everything. Mahipal will give you all those details. Don't have to worry about it. I'm just asking any generic questions everyone has. Okay.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay. So the prasadam is in Vrindavan Hall. Does everyone know where the Vrindavan Hall is?
Yeah,
no. Okay. And how many of you have come for the first time? Okay. So I would say you all can meet me immediately after this and then go for prasadam. Remaining all of you can go to Vrindavan Hall. Okay. ओके थैंक यू सो मच श्रील प्रभुपाद की जय।